For thousands of years, I've been lost to the world. My name means nothing to you. My memory is dust. Only the names of my father and brothers are remembered, their tales celebrated in your holy text. While mine is but a footnote, sad, violent, all but forgotten. It wasn't meant to be that way, but the chain between mother and daughter was broken, and the word passed to the keeping of men. Men too invested in the origins of the 12 tribes of Israel to bother with the life of one simple girl. Me, Dina, Jacob's only daughter. But if you asked me, I would tell you a different story. One that began with the red tent and the women who raised me. Dina! For I was also the daughter of Jacob's four wives. And it was here, in the sacred place where the women went to bleed during the full moon, that I came to know the secrets and wisdom and love of my mothers. Four half-sisters born of the same father. A cruel and stingy man named Laban, who cursed the gods for only giving him daughters. His oldest, my mother Leah, was strong and capable and splendidly arrogant. My aunt Rachel possessed a beauty as powerful as it was unearthly, and she wielded it like a sword. My aunt Zilpa and Bila were Laban's daughters by a slave wife and were given to Jacob as part of Leah and Rachel's dowries, although he never treated them as lesser wives. I can still hear their laughter, the songs and stories they spun like gold, and the sacred rituals passed down from their mothers. For the gods we worshipped in secret. In the cool shade of the red tent, they handed down their memories to me like gifts. And it was through their voices that I came to discover my own. But if my story began with my mother's, theirs began the day my father walked into their camp.
Water! My dad.
Shh. Drink.
My eyes tell me I must be.
Why, what do they say?
Her face. Too beautiful to leave this world.
My name is Rachel. And you are not dead.
He was looking for this camp, and they've been walking for days, and then he fainted from fever right at my feet. I brought him back to life, and he kissed me.
Stop.
He said we were cousins.
Tabling,
and... What did you do?
I kissed him back. He said he couldn't.
Are you sure it isn't you who's got the fever kissing a man?
You wouldn't
neck.
Understand. You know nothing of
also
that.
Silence, all of you!
Uncle, I am Jacob, son of Isaac and your sister Rebecca. She has sent me here asking that you welcome me as your kinsman, and allow me to earn my keeper's protector of your domain.
And your father's domain? Who's protecting that?
My brother, Esau. He and I... There is no longer a place for me there.
Oh. We'll see if you can tend to my flocks as well as you did my daughter. There. See to the needs of our kinsmen.
Cousin?
Leah.
From that moment on, her heart was his. That first year, Jacob made good on his promise to Laban. While falling deeper under Rachel's spell.
Oh my God!
I'm gonna try.
So, Bela, which one will it be?
This one.
You sure? He's the runt.
That's why he needs me.
And your sister needs help with the milking.
All right. Thank you, Jacob.
It's kind of you.
I was only going to sell three or four of them anyway.
I'll fetch you a good price once I've trained them.
You've done well here, Jacob. Barely a year and the herd's almost doubled. The wool is finer. The goats are fat.
I had the counsel of someone very wise to help me.
You give my father too much credit. We both know he's a lazy fool.
It wasn't your father I was speaking of.
Did Jacob tell you?
Father's finally agreed to a bride price. We're married next week.
I'm glad. For both of you. I know how long you've waited.
Make sure to only use the best yarns. I want to look perfect.
If Jacob remembers anything of your wedding night, it will be what you look like out of your clothes, not in them.
I always thought Leia'd be the first, since she is the bravest.
Are you sure you're ready for it? Zilpa, you'll make her nervous.
She should be. It's one thing to please a man with kisses, it's another to please him down there.
Jacob will be patient. He'll help her.
When have you ever seen a male be patient when he's in the throes of mating?
Well, maybe that's how the goats and sheep do it. My Jacob would never be that vile.
They can't help it.
Now you've upset her.
She needed to know.
Jacob was dancing like this.
In the name of Inanna, through whom all life flows.
To complete the marriage ceremony, you need to walk around him three times.
Oh, I'm getting a bit dizzy.
As she takes her final step
into womanhood. Three times, watch your posture. Keep your head up.
I'm not sure if I can do it anymore.
Guide her in the duties of a wife.
Jacob looks so happy.
And bless this union.
Watch your posture.
This is going to be a great
wedding. As you ready her.
To walk around the three times.
Stop. I can't do this. I won't.
Calm yourself, sister. You're acting like a child. I don't care. I'm not ready for this. You had to tell Father that I've changed my mind.
I can't tell him that. Everything's been arranged. Jacob is out there waiting.
And take my place.
Sister, no.
What? Please, Leia. I'm afraid do this for me. I beg you. Jacob will never know it, so you'll be hidden under the bridal veil.
And when he takes it off me? When we're inside the tent?
Don't let him. Say that you're shy and you want to keep it on just for the first time. After that, it won't matter. The marriage will be consummated, and you'll have to accept it.
And all you?
She was so scared. I'm sorry.
I'm not. Thank you.
Show me what to do.
How are you feeling?
Hungry.
What is it?
I'm not used to seeing you laugh.
I'm not used to being happy.
Show me what to do.
You repay my hard work and loyalty by duping me into a marriage I did not want?
What have you done?
Don't pretend this ruse was anyone else's idea but yours. You saw an opportunity to marry off your eldest daughter, and you took it. You drugged me with strong wine so I would not realize until too late that I had wed this harridan instead of my beloved. I kept my oath and bedded her as was my duty. But make no mistake, I do not consider her my wife until Rachel is also mine. For twice the price you originally offered me.
And why would I agree to give some miserable shepherd two of my daughters?
Four. I'll take Zilpah and Billa as dowries for the other two. And you'll agree to it, because this miserable shepherd has earned you more profit in 1 year than you would normally see in 20. And even you aren't stupid enough to give that up.
Rosie!
Never lie to me again.
Over the next 10 years, the camp doubled in size. Jacob took on several bondsmen and their families, and the tribe prospered.
Thank you. I'll bring it to him. It took Leia and Rachel years to learn how to share a husband. Each one longed for what the other could give him. It was Rachel he loved the most, deeply and to his very soul. But it was Leia who bore him sons, one after the other, while Rachel remained childless.
That's it. One more big push.
And though her skills as a midwife earned her a place of honor amongst all the tribes in Haran, her golden hands, delivering more babies than she could count, it was never enough.
It's beautiful. You should give it to someone more deserving.
More deserving than my wife? It was supposed to make you happy.
You know, there is only one thing that can make me happy. And for years, I have failed you.
Is that why you think I lie with you? To produce sons? No. I love. I lie with you tonight. Every night we share. Because you are my heart. There can be no truer wife than that.
Whether it was a simple twist of fate or the gods' sense of irony, Rachel conceived a child that night. She gave birth to my brother, Joseph, whose dreams would one day divine the future.
Simon, Levi, can you help me finish this?
I'll do it, Mother.
You shouldn't be carrying this.
Reuben, keep an eye on your brothers. Your mother needs rest.
So you all know then? Oh. Seven sons I've borne. I love them all. I don't think I have the strength to carry this one. I don't think I'll survive it.
Yes, you will.
How do you know?
Because you have us. And because your little girl is going to need you. Let us be your strength. I promise you, Leia, you will not leave this world. And we will bring your daughter into it.
Our daughter. She will belong to all of us.
Mm-hmm. One more
It'll be over soon.
You have a daughter!
I was born in the Red Tent during springtime. Leia pronounced my name, and Silpa said she heard music in it. The first syllable, high and clear, as when a mother calls to a child at dusk. The second one, soft, for whispering on pillows.
Dina.
Dina!
Joseph! Father and Reuben are back!
My Dina.
And my golden boy, Joseph.
Welcome back, Father.
Golden boy, huh? Golden boy.
Levi, Simon, help Reuben unload the grain.
Oh, look. Oh, Joseph. Oh, how beautiful.
Jacob, is that what my sheep are buying now? Presents. For your precious children.
They would have bought a lot more if you hadn't lost half of them to pay off your gambling debts.
Are you deaf, you stupid woman? I told you to get me some more wine. Come on, get up.
You've had enough. And so is she.
Oh, and I suppose we have to look to you as Lord Master now, do we?
Better to me than a useless drunk. You keep it up, we'll have nothing left.
What I do with my property is none of your business.
It is when it affects my family.
Your family wouldn't exist without my generosity. You do well to remember that, Jacob. This is my land. You and your sons work for me.
Not anymore.
Is that supposed to scare me?
It should. Send your mother to me, quickly.
Ruti! Get back here!
Mira is in labor. We need an extra pair of hands.
A good apprentice is never late. You're lucky the child waited.
Forgive me. My father needs to see you. It's urgent.
Massage her belly like this. What essential oils did I use?
Lavender and jasmine to dull the pain. And cedarwood to relax her muscles.
Why did Jacob want to see your mother?
We're moving.
Where will we go?
Shechem.
Is that a long journey from here?
Long and difficult. I'll take us through my father's land. I must see Esau. He's my brother, and I wronged him.
It was a long time ago. You were very young.
Not so young that I didn't know what I was doing. I need to make amends and beg his forgiveness.
Are you sure he will give it?
No. I only know it'll haunt me forever if I don't try.
You're a good man.
Even though I'm uprooting our family, taking you far from home.
Our home is wherever you are.
How will the women react?
Loudly. You tell our sons and the shepherds, let the women hear it from me.
Go to sleep. It'll be all right.
You're going?
Simon, please. I need to see Father.
He's busy with important matters.
Levi, this is important.
Then give me the message and I'll pass it on to him.
You'd only get it confused.
Leave it, Simon. She should act more like a proper girl.
And you should act less like our grandfather.
I'm sorry for interrupting, Father, but I needed to speak with you right away. It's about Ruti. We have to take her with us. You have seen what he does to her. She will die if she's left alone here.
She's your grandfather's wife, his property. I cannot take what isn't mine.
You could offer to buy her. Here. You could take these. You could sell these, Father. Pay him whatever he wants.
The only thing Laban wants is to deny me whatever he can. I could offer him half my herd. It wouldn't be enough. Trust me. I know this.
And I know that we have to try, because if we don't, we are no better than he is.
I'll ask him. You have my word.
Thank you.
Go on. Off you go.
He has agreed to take Ruti with us. How are we going to hide the idols? Father says we must only worship his one god.
These belong to my mother, and her mother before that. Your father will be angry if he finds it, but they are part of us, Dina. I love Jacob with all my heart, but this is who we are. He has his ways, we have ours.
Rachel, are you truly glad to be moving?
Of course.
Haven't you ever wondered what's beyond these hills? Things you've never seen. Valleys and rivers, cities with walled houses full of new people to meet.
A husband, perhaps? Who knows? Maybe true love is waiting for you there, right at this very moment.
As true as yours and Jacob's?
Could be.
That's how I will fall in love. Just like you and Father.
And you will be very lucky.
I'll be luckier.
Why is that?
Because I won't share him. The man I marry, he would love only me.
Luckier and smarter.
An upside-down fig tree.
Good one. Mm-hmm. There. A man running.
That's a very fat man. Oh, next to him.
It's you riding a camel.
I've always wanted to do that.
You will. One day.
Have you seen it? In one of your dreams?
Not exactly. Oh. I told you, it doesn't work that way.
Then what did you see?
You. On a journey. Farther than what we're about to take. As far as another world, it seemed.
Dying lamb. Dina.
Jacob, you want to buy my wife?
You've never thought of her as anything but your slave. You treated her far worse than even that.
Don't you dare preach to me!
No!
This is your doing. Looks like she saved you some money.
Get everyone ready. We're leaving.
Oh,
forward.
Walking makes me tired. And hungry and bored. I wish it would rain.
Ach, Dina.
How many more days until we're there?
A few.
You've been saying that ever since we left, and that's 3 moons ago.
Then stop asking.
Joseph?
Yeah. How did your father seem today?
He's the same. He didn't sleep again last night. He's worried that he didn't send enough gift for the messengers.
Not messengers.
Father sent some of the shepherds ahead to warn Esau if we were coming.
Warn him? Why, you make it sound as though he won't be happy to see us.
Why are we stopping?
We must be near the river.
The river? Can I have a look for it, please? I've never seen one.
Yes, Joseph goes with him.
Oh,
stop here for the night.
So soon? It's only midday.
We could easily make it across the river.
Reuben, get the others to start making camp.
Yes, Father.
Perhaps if one of us shared his tent tonight, it might calm him. It should be you.
I found some yarrow root. The brew should help him sleep.
I'll bring it to him. Dina.
I'll bring it.
Go on, then. Bila made you this.
Messengers should have returned by now.
Perhaps Esau is putting together gifts of his own to send back with him.
I'm a traitor. He owes me nothing.
How did you betray him?
I listened to someone I shouldn't have. Someone who convinced me that I deserved my father's blessing more than my older brother did. So I tricked Esau out of his birthright and made it my own. When he found out, I was too afraid to face him, so I fled. His home, the lands I tried to steal, are just beyond the river. And I can't bring myself to cross it. I'm as much a coward now as I was then.
A coward would not have come here. I don't think we can be brave without first feeling fear. And you're wrong that Esau owes you nothing. You are his brother.
Did you become so wise?
I listened to my mother.
Esau's on his way here with an army of 100 men.
Spring the carts! Quickly, go! Move! Quickly! Reuben, line them up! Reuben, Sam and Levi, stay close to me. The rest of you get the women and children behind the carts. Guard them with your lives. Quickly!
Safe.
They're here!
stay here. Is it really you?
Oh, Jacob. Praise God.
Forgive me.
Brother, I forgave you long ago.
I've come to welcome you home.
The mark of great men lies in their ability to forgive. Isolf and his men led us back to his camp, where we were to meet my grandmother, Rebecca, the greatest oracle in all of Canaan. My father had rarely spoken of her.
She's smarter than I imagine.
She can divine the future. There's nothing small about that.
Hello, Mother.
Welcome home.
This is my family. This is Reuben, my firstborn. My next two, Simon and Levi, also by Leah. This is Joseph, my son with Rachel. Leah, my first wife. And Dina, our only daughter.
Are you not afraid of me?
Should I be?
How long will you stay?
Reuben and I will leave tomorrow for Shisham to petition the king for some land. The rest of the family will remain here while I'm gone.
Good. You'll bring this one to me. It's time I got to know my granddaughter.
Why does she want me and not Joseph? He's the one with her gift.
You're my only daughter. Perhaps she has some wisdom to impart.
Father, who are all these people?
Pilgrims, waiting to see Rebecca.
Why?
Most of them are suffering in some way, from poverty or sickness. They travel from far and wide to have their fortunes read, hoping she'll tell them something better lies ahead.
And does she?
Always.
You will help Werenro bring the pilgrims in and out, collect their gifts, and thank them for their offerings.
Yes, Grandmother.
Oh, don't worry. I won't ruin her.
You couldn't if you tried.
How long has it been, Jacob?
25 years. Mm.
27. And look at you. You've done well for yourself. And I was right to send you to Laban.
And I was right to leave him.
Oh, we'll see, won't we?
Goodbye, Mother.
While Reuben and Jacob left us to petition the king for some land, I helped Berenro, my grandmother's slave.
This way.
You seek, they are not far. You must endure, and I promise you will find them.
Thank you.
There weren't as many today.
There'll be more tomorrow.
How did you get those scars?
It's how Rebecca marks all her slaves.
She cut you?
She made my mother do it when I became old enough to serve.
I thought you understood. Go, just go. You were given specific instructions about the pilgrims. It was not your place to do more for them.
These people are starving, Grandmother. I have never seen people so poor, and yet they bring gifts they cannot afford to part with and give to you, who needs nothing.
If I refuse their gifts, would they accept mine? Dina, it's not for you to decide. It's true. I have no need for their gifts. But if I tell them that their worldly possessions mean nothing to me, I will have robbed them of something far more valuable than a bowl or a tapestry. I've taken their dignity, and that I will not do.
Except to a slave.
You speak very boldly for one so young. Your father has indulged you with too much freedom. An unfortunate consequence when a child is favored.
It was you who told him to betray Esau, wasn't it? He was your favorite, and you wanted him to be heir.
Jacob was very special to me, but there was more to it than that. And my husband was going blind, and the tribe needed a new patriarch, and Jacob had talents that his older brother did not. I knew Esau could never be a leader.
That's not what I saw down at the river that day. Perhaps your gift isn't as great as you think.
Careful, girl. Like it or not, you and I are blood. Joseph may have my gift, but you are far more kin to me than he will ever be. You just don't know it yet. You prefer to think we are different because I would chastise a slave and you would not.
No, I think we're different because I would never want to own one. The only thing you and I have in common is my father. And you lost him.
As will you, my dear. And you will bear it, as I have, because you are strong. But it will come at a great price. And cause you a lifetime of sorrow. I've seen it.
was the last time I ever saw her.
The merchants we've spoken to all say that the opportunities for trading
are far... I've told you. We're shepherds, not traders.
Father, there are easier ways to make our fortune.
Enough.
Dina, hurry! I can see the city!
If Joseph saw the darkness that lay ahead, he said nothing to us. Perhaps he knew that Jacob could never be persuaded to abandon the path his God had chosen.
Father, look!
That's Shechem, where the king lives.
Where's Arlan?
See that ridge just beyond the city? That's our new home.
Or perhaps it was simply that Joseph wanted to believe, as we all did, in a better dream. Soon you'll join us in the red tent. There's nothing to be afraid of. You'll see, once you spend time there.
What of our husbands?
Well, they're not invited.
Father!
Both wells are dry.
Are you sure?
This land is not what the king promised. He has cheated us.
We should go to Shechem and protest. Our tribe will appear weak.
What would you advise?
You're asking the opinion of a boy.
A boy who sees things you cannot.
I would preach caution before accusing King Hemor of dishonor. Might there be other well sites?
You should look. See what you find.
Father, we could be digging for weeks.
Then do it. Your brother is right.
Of course our brother is right. Isn't he always?
Doesn't matter that it will be the rest of us breaking our banks to
find a new well. Joseph has a pretty coat to match his pretty dreams. So he must know best.
And one day, it's going to get him into trouble.
Great Mother. We have been blessed with two more daughters, Rhoda and Tamar, the wives of our sons Simon and Levi.
And we ask that you welcome them as we have into your loving embrace.
We understand this is all new for you.
The great mother whom we call Inanna gave a gift to women that is not known among men. That is the secret of blood.
Men see in it only pain. They believe we suffer and they consider themselves lucky.
It's we who are the lucky ones. For we alone have the power to give life. In the Red Tent, we surround ourselves with healing hands and loving voices. And we give thanks for the knowledge that life comes from between our legs. And that the cost of life is blood. Here in the Red Tent, we rejoice in Inanna's gift. We honor her by celebrating the first blood of our daughters, catching it and returning it to the earth so that it may go back to the great mother's womb.
Daughters of Inanna, great mothers of us all.
We had kept our faith separate from those of the men, but my brother's wives were not born to these beliefs. And in their fear, they told their husbands the secrets of the Red Tent.
Father, how could you allow this? They were worshipping idols and chanting about blood like they were witches.
Enough! Where are they? You false gods. Where are they? The idols!
No!
If I'd known this is what you were hiding in here.
This is the realm of women. You do not belong here.
I will tear this place down!
And you will tear it down with us in it!
What did you say?
Jacob, forgive her. She's drugged with sleep. She doesn't know what she's saying.
I know exactly what I am saying, and
apologize for your insolence! How could she have submitted him like that when she knew he was wrong?
She was just trying to protect you.
His anger was misplaced, you know. Simon Levi provoked him. And you've me to blame for that.
They resent the way that Father favors me. I need to find a way to make peace with him. Or things are gonna get even worse.
A member of the king's household is delivering a child. He has heard that one of your women is a gifted midwife.
My wife, Rachel. But I do not wish to part with her today.
Perhaps if the king was to offer some reward for honoring his request,
Simon. You might...
This is not a request. It's a command.
Never speak for me again. Ever. You'd never lie to me.
I asked you to renounce your god in favor of my own, would you do it?
Rachel, if you're trying to defend yourself...
I'm trying to defend our way. The ways of our mothers and their mothers. Wise women, all of them. Believing in something that is no more threat to your god than I am.
There are things we hold sacred, Jacob. Things you cannot understand as no man could. It isn't meant to hurt you.
Well, I can't fight you both. I suppose I have no choice but to send one of you away. Let's hope it's for no more than a day. I wouldn't want you to get used to life in a palace.
Palace?
King's Court needs a midwife. They've asked for you.
I will need an assistant. Someone whose skills I can trust.
Then the only woman for that would be your apprentice.
And who will watch over her?
I will, sister.
Swindled by this King Hamor, and still father submits to him.
My name is Dina. This is my Aunt Rachel. She's the best midwife you could ever have. I promise you we're not going to leave your side.
Thank you. It won't be long. Send a servant for linens. Fresh, as many as she can bring.
The midwives are here, my queen.
Check the baby's position. Breathe through it. She's ready. We have the linens. Dina, get the bricks. Come. Oh, the servant's here. Okay. Oh, well, you'll do. Here, we need more hands.
She's the queen.
Dina, she's the queen. She... Oh, forgive me. It's an honor to meet you. If you just stand across from me, we can actually support Abby under her arms while Rachel catches the baby. And under arm. Good. Okay. Have you ever witnessed a birth before?
I have given birth, but never witnessed one. Never like this.
Well, it's a miracle. Hold on to her. Okay. Breathe. I know you can. Push. My aunt, the midwife. Why are you here?
I live here.
In the palace?
My name is Shalem. I'm King Hamor's son.
Oh, so Queen Renifer is your mother?
Are you mad? Oh, was she unkind to you?
Oh, no. No, but she could have been. I need to find the well.
It's through there. Would you like me to join you?
I was very impressed with your niece. She's a strong young woman.
Headstrong, some might say.
Still. It's rare to see in this city. Most of the Shishem women are silly and stupid. Not like the ones in Egypt where I come from.
You do not have a daughter?
Only a son, whom I love with all my heart. But it's not the same. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Do you know how to swim?
Of course. Can you?
Where I grew up, the only water I saw came from a well or fell from a sky. I never smelled this sweet.
All that is the scent of the lotus flower. In Egypt, they're considered sacred.
Why?
Well, because they're timeless. A symbol of birth and rebirth. At night, they close up, retracting into the water, but each day they open up again. Their blooms reborn.
My mothers would love that story. They really smell like perfume.
They say it's powerful enough to make even the ducks and fish swoon.
And what makes you swoon?
Looking at you.
Rachel, he's here.
Who?
I don't think I would see him again. But he is real and is just like you said. It's like a storm. His name is Shalem and he's the son of the king and the queen.
What have you done?
Nothing you yourself didn't do when you fell in love with father.
In love? You've just met him.
So you knew right away. You said I'd be lucky if it ever happened to me, and it has happened.
We'll talk about it on the way home. We need to leave right away if we're to make it back before dark. Let's go.
I'm afraid you cannot leave. At least not Dina. The king has asked that she stay on a few days to help Abby during her confinement.
I will have to ask her father for permission. He's a man of honor,
as is my husband. Have no fear. We shall take good care of her.
My guards will escort you back to your camp.
Dina, listen to me. Remember who you are and where you come from. Be humble and protect your honor.
What was that you spoke?
Egyptian. I was schooled there. My mother's family's from Thebes.
So you've been across the sea then?
I have.
Was it very beautiful?
Not as beautiful as you.
You aren't as I imagined a prince would be.
Because I intimidate you.
Because you don't.
If this prince wanted to kiss you...
I would tell him he must bring me things first.
Like?
Like flowers. jewels.
Anything else?
But why the daughter of a shepherd?
Dina is as worthy as any princess. Father, when you get to know her, you'll understand.
I understand that you are young and brash.
That is true. But I know in my heart that this is right. She's the one I want to share my life with.
What is it?
A gift.
It's beautiful. How do I look?
Like the future queen of Shishem.
You talked to your father? He consented?
Assuming your father says yes, should we ask him for permission first? Or...
I will decide who I marry, not him. This is my life. My future. My choice.
Majesty, my name is Jacob. These are my people. What business do we have together?
None, Jacob. We are family now. My son has married your daughter.
She wouldn't.
I bring you this handsome bride price. Let us all celebrate their union, and may we all prosper.
Did you know about this?
No.
Why was I not consulted?
You're displeased? Surely you can't object to the match.
I object to the way it has come about.
Even so, we can't go back. They are already living together as husband and wife.
Who married them? You?
They married each other, as is our custom.
It is not ours.
Come, Jacob. We are brothers now. Swallow your pride. I have swallowed mine.
You talk of pride. What of respect?
I'm offering you a bride price fit for a princess of Egypt. More than my father gave for my wife. Not that Dinar isn't worthy, but surely you can't want her back. She is no longer a virgin. And what's more, my son is in love with her. Name your price, and I will pay it.
My daughter's honor is not for sale. I need to think on this. I will speak to my sons and give you my answer in 2 days' time.
Jacob, I understand you're angry, but think of your daughter. Shalem is a prince. She couldn't have made a better match.
She made it without my consent, which never would have happened if you hadn't left her there.
I was commanded by the king.
I am your king. You answer to me.
Leia, wait.
You may not have admitted it to Jacob, but you tell me the truth. Did you know about this?
Only that they met. It all happened so fast.
Of course it did. Ever since she was born, you've been filling her head with romantic ideas about love. And look what it brought. Dishonor on her. Dishonor on this family.
There is no dishonor in finding true love. Dina is a woman now, with her own mind and her own desires.
And your impulsiveness.
And your good sense. She found what she was looking for, Leia. Dishonor would only come to her if Jacob forced her to return home with her virginity taken and her future ruined.
What do you suggest we do now?
Whatever we can to help her.
My mother and my aunts will be moving into the tent soon.
How do you know that?
The moon is almost full.
And what will they do in this tent when no men are allowed?
Jealous?
Of course.
Well, they'll be lighting candles and incense. Laughing, gossiping, tell stories.
And stories about what?
About themselves, each other. Mostly about people they once loved and they want to remember. And that way, people never really die. Hmm. It's just like with the lotus flower. Hmm. My mother once said, to mourn is respectful, to remember is holy.
And when we're withered and old someday, what will you remember most about us?
wasn't so long ago that I was standing at a well like this, and you appeared out of nowhere after Lirius. What happened with Dina and Charlene is no more sudden than what happened with us.
I fell in love with you at the well. Did I take you then and there? No. I went to your father and agreed to his terms before I could marry you. Believe me, the waiting was agony. But I did it out of respect for him and for you.
And because it was your custom. But if you'd been from a different tribe with your own traditions, I would have honored them. Just as Dina has honored Shalem's. Have you forgotten what it's like to love someone that much?
How do we know that she wasn't forced into it? What if she was raped?
Exactly. How dare you speak of our sister like that?
Really?
No,
I cannot change what has already been done. The marriage has been consummated. I have asked for your counsel on determining a reasonable bride price.
If the king wants to show respect for our tribe, he should pay us a fortune as great as
his land. It's not about money, it's about his honor, not for making a profit.
What honor? It was taken by that uncircumcised dog when he's
not a brother. What would you suggest? That Shalem pays tribute with his own foreskin as a bride price?
Well, why not?
I don't see a problem with that.
Better yet, demand the foreskins of all the men of Shishet.
Silence!
Abraham took up the knife for those in his household who were not of his covenant. If the men of Shashem agree to this, then no man can say that Dina was injured.
Father, I didn't mean that way.
No, you're right. This way our tradition will continue, and Dina's sons will be circumcised too.
But you will still accept the king's gold.
We don't need gold. What we need is for our customs and beliefs to carry on and grow. Joseph's idea ensures this.
What barbarity is this? Who do you think you are to demand my son's manhood? And mine. And my kinsmen and subjects?
Father! Jacob, I agree to your terms. The king speaks out of fear for me and loyalty to his men who will suffer. If this is the custom of my wife's family, then we will honor it. Forgive me for having offended you. I should have come to you first and sought your approval, but you must know I love your daughter. I want to be with her no matter the price. She's half of me already.
What does it look like?
Like we are going to be planning a wedding feast.
Get some of the shepherds to help us. It'll be easier to persuade than our brothers.
You shouldn't need many. Every man in the city will be incapacitated. There'll be no one to fight back.
Tomorrow night, then. We'll get our revenge and our reward. And Father will never overlook us again.
I won't let you do it. How dare my father think he can cut you?
Well, he won't be doing it. That would be rather awkward.
How can you joke about it? You could die.
Come here.
No.
It's only a flesh wound. I'd suffer far worse if I couldn't have you.
He had no right to ask such a thing. No wife is worth that.
He had every right. You're worth that and much, much more.
Shalem? Shalem? Shalem!
They began at dawn. Our husbands first, then the rest. It should be over soon.
I'm sorry.
In Egypt, they circumcise boys when their voices change. My father, my brothers, they all survived it easily. Our husbands will too.
I just don't understand why Shalem would agree to such a thing.
He must love you very much.
From the palace for Dina's wedding.
Besides the king and the queen.
Guards, servants.
Oh, Leia will have us cooking weeks ahead.
All of you had sons. You don't know what it's like to let go of a daughter.
She's ours, too. And together we have raised a wild girl into a strong, beautiful woman.
We have, haven't we?
I love you too.
am only a daughter.
I am nothing more than a piece of property.
Tomorrow, the epic conclusion.
It's time for this to end.
Not when they have suffered as I have.
She has no right to keep you here. This is my life now.
Jacob!
You murdered her. Do you have any idea of the shame that will rain down on us?
Don't miss the highly anticipated finale of The Red Tent tomorrow at 9 on Lifetime.